Hello, dear students. Today onwards, I wish to discuss about the unit 3 in paper 2, that is oxygen reductant systems, principles and applications in analysis. So in our syllabi, we have totally 8 oxidant and reductant systems. So in this 3 categories are there. First one, inorganic oxidant systems. They are Mn3, Mn7, cerium 4 and chromium 6. Next, inorganic reductant systems, chromium 2, vanadium 2, titanium 3. And then organic oxidant systems, only one example is there, that is chloramine T. In today's class, I wish to discuss about the manganese 7, that is potassium permanganate. Which is a powerful oxidizing agent. Generally, this potassium permanganate is used as oxidizing agent by Margaret in 1846 for the titration of ferrous iron, that is Fe2. Generally, in acid solution, the potassium permanganate is a strong oxidant. Generally, it represented as MnO4 minus, it is permanganate ion. In the presence of acid, it gains electrons to produce Mn2 plus and 4 mole of H2O. Here, the potential value is 1.51 volts. Sulfuric acid is most suitable acid because sulfate ions has no action upon KMnO4. Of course, if you use hydrochloric acid, then this hydrochloric acid is not recommended because chloride ion may react with MnO4 minus, which results the formation of chlorine gas. So if you use HCl as acid medium for permanganate titration, then it can produce chlorine gas, which interferes with the titration, which disturbs the titration. So in this above reaction, it is frequently takes place in iron ore analysis. Why? Because in iron ore analysis, the iron ore sample is dissolved in HCl solution. So this reaction always takes place in the titration of KMnO4 when you use iron ore sample analysis. So by taking special precautions, the interaction of chloride with permanganate ion may be prevented. So the special precautions are like this. First one, titration is carried out with a small excess of free acid. So a very little diluted solution of HCl, you can titrate it at low temperatures by using low temperatures and slow titration with constant shaking. So for best results, it is best to add about 25 ml Zimmermann and Reinhardt's solution. So it is a different solution. So it can be made by mixing 50 gram of MnSO4 and 400 ml of 1:3 H2SO4 and 100 ml of phosphoric acid. Then finally add 250 ml water. This mixture of solution is called as Zimmermann-Reinhardt's solution. So if you wanted to get best results, then you can add this Zimmermann-Reinhardt's solution. So in the preventive solution, MnSO4 decreases the reduction potential of Mn7+ and Mn2+, this reductant system, and also reduces Mn3+ and Mn2+ potential. Okay, right. So whereas H3PO4 increases the oxidation potential of Fe2+ and Fe3+ couple by complexing with Fe3+. So phosphoric acid can combine with the Fe3+ to produce this complex. Thus it renders the endpoint more clearly visible. Okay, right. So in the presence of Zimmermann and Reinhardt solution, permanganate ion oxidizes Fe2+ rapidly and reacts slowly with chloride ion. So by adding Zimmermann-Reinhardt's solution also, you can prevent the interferences of chloride ion. Okay, next. Potassium permanganate may also employ in strongly alkaline solution. Permanganate is reduced to manganate. So if you use the strongly alkaline solution, the reactions like this, and here are the potential values. Okay, in moderately alkaline solution, MnO4- is reduced to MnO2. So this is the reaction, and you can get the potential value here like this. So up to this we have discussed about the introduction to KMnO4. Okay, right. Next, what is the stability of KMnO4? Generally, KMnO4 is not a primary standard solution because it is not obtained perfectly pure. It contains some MnO2. Okay, right. So the aqueous solution of KMnO4 is unstable because the ordinary distilled water may contain some reducing substances. They will react with KMnO4 to form MnO2. So the presence of MnO2, is objectionable because it catalyzes the auto decomposition of KMnO4 solution on standing. Generally, what happens is if MnO2 is present, then this reaction takes place. So KMnO4 is inherently unstable in the presence of Mn2+. So if Mn2+ is present, then automatically this permanganate ion can combine with Mn2+ in the presence of H2O, can produce MnO2. Okay, so this above reaction is slow in acid but very rapid in neutral condition. So this neutral solution, in the presence of neutral solution, this reaction is very rapid. And one more thing is, the bottle which is used for the storage of KMnO4 solution must be cleaned with chromic acid in order to remove any organic matter. Why? Because any organic matter may reduce the KMnO4. So that is the reason why it should be removed by or cleaned with chromic acid. KMnO4 solution must be protected from unnecessary exposure of light. A dark colored bottle is recommended to store the solution. Why? Because it may interfere with the KMnO4. Okay, so till now we have discussed about the introduction to KMnO4 and stability of KMnO4 solution. Now let us discuss how to prepare the KMnO4 solution. Simple. Just weigh about 3.2 to 3.25 gram of KMnO4 on watch glass, then transfer it into 1500 ml beaker, then add 1 liter of water. Next, cover the beaker with watch glass and heat up to 15 to 30 minutes, and cool it to room temperature. So next, filter the solution through centered glass funnel, and filtrate is stored in a clean glass toppered bottle and kept in a dark place when not in use. Okay, simple. You need to weigh 3.2 to 3.25 gram of KMnO4, transfer it into a beaker, add 1 liter water, heat it up to boiling for 15 to 30 minutes. After that, cool it to room temperature, filter it, then store it in a glass toppered bottle. While storing, you need to prefer the ambered colored bottle. Okay, next, standardization of KMnO4. So to standardize KMnO4, why? Because you know very well, we already discussed about the stability of KMnO4. The KMnO4 is not stable, so that is the reason why you need to standardize the KMnO4 solution. For standardization of KMnO4 solution, you can use either arsenic 3 oxide or sodium oxalate solution for the standardization. Okay, so for standardization against arsenic 3 oxide, so standardization of KMnO4 against arsenic 3 oxide. So dry some arsenic oxide crystals at 105 degrees Celsius to 110 degrees Celsius for 1 or 2 hours and allow to cool in a desiccator. Just arsenic crystals must be dehydrated. Next, weigh about approximately 0.25 gram of dry arsenic oxide transferred into 400 ml beaker. Then add 10 ml of 20% NaOH solution and 100 ml of water and allow to stand for 8 to 10 minutes with shaking. Then what happens is, this arsenic oxide, whenever you add this sodium hydroxide, it can react with hydroxide ions to produce this. After that, add 100 ml water, 10 ml HCl and 1 drop of potassium iodide or potassium iodate solution. Then this is the sample solution preparation, standard solution preparation. So after that, run down KMnO4 solution from the burette until a faint pink color persists for 30 seconds, until it gives a pale pink color. So repeat the titration with two other similar quantities of arsenic oxide and then calculate the concentration. Okay, then this is the reaction. You can observe here, this is the reaction where the arsenic acid can combine with the permanganate in the presence of acid to produce these products. Okay, just reduction of this one and oxidation of this one. Okay, why? Because potassium permanganate is oxidizing agent. So this is the way to standardize KMnO4 solution by using arsenic 3 oxide. Of course, you can use another method for the standardization of KMnO4, that is standardization of KMnO4 against sodium oxalate. It is the well known method. Sodium oxalate is readily obtained pure and anhydrous state. The purity of the material is at least 99.99%. The reaction between oxalic acid and KMnO4 solution is like this. So sodium oxalate in the presence of acid media can react with sodium oxalate. It can produce oxalic acid. This oxalic acid can combine with the permanganate. Okay, right. So this is the way to standardize KMnO4 solution. Next, what are the indicators used? Listen carefully, you know very well, generally KMnO4 acts as self-indicator. Why? Because it is pink in color. Just for titrations with colorful or slightly colored solutions of permanganate, the use of indicator is not necessary. Why? Because permanganate is a colored solution. Because if you take 0.01 ml of 0.02 molar KMnO4 solution, if you add even less than a drop of that KMnO4 solution, if you add 100 ml water, then it imparts pale pink color. Okay, if more dilute solutions are used, then the intensity of the dilute solutions may be enhanced by the following indicators. The indicators used are generally rare cases. In rare cases, we use these indicators. They are sodium diphenylamine sulfonate, N-phenylanthranilic acid, and ferrine indicator. These are rare conditions. In rare conditions, we use indicators for KMnO4 titrations. Okay. So till now, we discussed about the introduction to KMnO4, stability of the KMnO4 solution. Stability of KMnO4 solution. Standardization of KMnO4 solution. Next, indicators which are used for KMnO4 titration. But keep it in mind, KMnO4 acts as self-indicator. Okay, right. If very dilute solutions, then you can use these indicators. Okay, right. So what are the applications? Analysis of peroxides. So from the sample solution, pipette out 25 ml of the solution into conical flask, then dilute it with water, then add 20 ml of 1:5 H2SO4 solution and titrate it with standard 0.02 molar KMnO4 solution to the pale pink color obtained. Okay, so this is the reaction which you can observe. Okay, right. Next, analysis of nitrites. Analysis of nitrites. Just for analysis of nitrites, weigh accurately 1.1 gram of potassium nitrate and place it in a 250 ml volumetric flask. So after that, you need to make up with distilled water, then fill it in a burette. Okay, transfer 25 ml of 0.202 molar KMnO4 solution into 500 ml conical flask, and then add 225 ml of 0.5 molar H2SO4 and heat up to 40 degrees Celsius. The solution is titrated slowly with nitrate solution. Here, keep it in mind, this solution is present in conical flask and you need to fill the burette with potassium nitrate solution with constant stirring until permanganate solution is just decolorized. Okay, right. Then this is the reaction takes place. Generally, if you wanted to get more accurate results, then you can use back titration method also. In back titration method, you need to add excess amount of KMnO4 solution to the nitrate solution and then back titrate it against ammonium ferrous sulfate solution. Okay, so in any oxidizing systems or reductant systems topic, you need to concentrate on the introduction of that particular reagent and then what is the stability of the solution that was prepared. Next, you need to discuss about preparation of the solution, after that standardization of the solution. Next, what are the indicators used? Next, what are the applications? Okay, thank you for your kind attention.